Hello, and welcome back to my garage. In today's video, I wanted to change the timing belt and the water pump of my mother's car, the Renault Clio, but I didn't have the proper tools for it, and I do think I can make a better instruction video for you guys if I use the proper tools. So now that I ordered them, and well, we have to wait for it. So this is going back into the box. And we're going to replace the brake discs and, of course, the pads. Let me unbox this for you. This is a set from Delphi. Delphi is a quality brand, no problems there. The only problem I have with Delphi is the supporting material. Like, they support sometimes if you buy, let's say, a new ball joint, then you get some new screws and bolts by with that, and most of the time those are really rubbish. I had to replace a ball joint, well, not long ago, and those nuts didn't even fit the bolts, so these stripped out completely and it was garbage. So the parts are really well, but the supporting material, I don't like that very much. Well, here we have the discs. These are looped up nicely. Be sure to clean them before you install it, or at least after you install it. And these are the brake pads, and they look just fine. Also, the supporting material I got with this kit is just looking okay. It's better than I used to see, so maybe it is a bit of a hit or miss, or maybe there are a couple of different factories are producing parts for them, but yeah, I think I have that ball joint around here somewhere. Maybe the supporting material is still in this box. Also, this isn't a rant on Delphi. Delphi makes great parts, so don't worry about that. Well, these are the nuts and bolts I got rid of. And as you can see, this is really fine fret, and the nuts I get with it are much more coarse. I think this is 125 and this is 1.5. I think I have to remeasure that, or maybe even 1.75. So of course, yeah, that doesn't fit. Also, these bolts are feeling great quality. Also, they are marked great quality, but marks doesn't say everything, but these feel like some really quality bolts. These nuts are really feeling cheap, cheap as it can be. It feels like one of those bolts in some assortment kit you can get at your hardware store. This feels like this. So yeah, it is a little bit hit or miss with Delphi. So again, I don't dislike Delphi, but sometimes the supporting parts are just not there. But then again, I got with, I look like a Coke dealer holding it like this. Oh well, welcome to Holland. Well, they did include some new bolts for the discs to keep them in place. But yeah, an offset. So let's get it on the car. Before I'm going to remove the caliper, I'm going to push back the piston as far as possible. The easiest way to do it is by just jamming a screwdriver between the pad and the brake disc, and just, well, yank it in there. But of course, don't do this if you want to reuse the brake discs, because you are going to damage them. But most of the time, this is just the easiest way to push back the piston. If the bolt is spinning, then use a wrench on the inside, and it is a 17. And then you can just Well, flip it. Like so. But then again, we're going to remove the whole assembly. So we can just pull it off and put it somewhere safe. So that's what we're doing. Now we can remove the old brake. The old brake pads, and hopefully you can see how bad the discs are. They are really in a bad shape. To remove the bracket, you need to undo these two bolts, and these are 18. So there we have the bracket. Normally I do these bolts first before even removing the caliper. The reason is that if you cannot undo this, then you can ask someone to stand on the brake, so it's nice and firm, and then you can have some more leverage to get it off. But if you've got one of these, then most of the time it isn't a problem. These can be really stuck on there, so just get yourself a hammer and go to town with it. Be sure that you don't hit yourself in the face. Yeah, I did it. These discs are really bad. As you can see, the inside is also not very nice to look at. So I went to the store because the disc brakes that I ordered, these, are much too small for that's needed on the car. There is just a lot of difference between them. I believe that the new ones are somewhere in the 25 centimeters, and these are 23. So there is a big difference. I ordered the wrong one, so be sure that you get the new ones. I do believe that this car came with three kinds of discs. One was 23 centimeters and something. Solid disc and vented discs. The solid discs were for vehicles without power steering. The vented discs are for cars with power steering but without ABS. And the 25 millimeters are for cars with power steering and ABS. So be sure that you get the right one for the car. This is from another brand, and this brand I am not very familiar with. I don't believe I ever installed something from them. And this is called Roadhouse. They were pretty cheap, but I'm not familiar with the brand. They got something good for them, because these also came with bolts for the discs. So that's a plus point. And they coated the edge of the discs and the head. Not the whole disc, because I do believe this isn't zinc. It looks more like a epoxy kind of coating. So the future will tell if they're any good or not. But at the first look, they look really like solid discs. So I'm not worried about to put it on the car, especially because it's my mom's car. As always, be sure to clean the hub as good as you can. I'm probably going to say, as always, a lot, because if you know my channel a little bit, I do a lot of brake videos and wheel bearing videos, and that's not because I don't want to do other stuff, but these are the most jobs I have, and because I don't have a garage for a living, I don't get a lot of other jobs, so yeah. Don't worry, I'm still working on other stuff. I'm still working on the Corolla. I definitely want to put another video of it online as soon as possible. But I just have some issues with editing. It's not like I want it to be. Maybe I'm just a little bit picky. But as you have seen, I mounted the discs. You should manage that also. Without a problem, of course. If you want to ruin your bits, do it like this. I think I already screwed up three of these. Be sure to clean up these seats where the pets are riding on. They don't have those metal clips in there, so we cannot replace them, of course. Next up, we can put the cradle back. And these are 18. They are still 18. But don't worry about the pads. The pads are on all those three kinds of discs the same. So you cannot order them wrong. This is an other pad. This is a pad from a Golf 4. A rear disc pad for a Golf 4. Okay, and where did I put the other one? What you want to do is be sure that you put some grease on these faces. I always use ceramic grease and sometimes copper grease or anti-seize, or what you want to do, or how do you want to call it. And after that, just a little bit on the brake pads itself. If they're stuck like this, you have two options. One is make the caliper a little bit cleaner, but sometimes you just have to remove a little bit of these faces. And that's why that's a good idea to test fit them first before looping them all up. Yeah, I know, I do stuff in the wrong order. What else is new? You want them that they're just snuck in there, but not stuck. This is just perfect. So again, a little bit of grease on there, and I probably made a big mess of the disc, but that will be clean later. Also, I do a little bit on these springs. Not really necessary, but I just like to do that. Be sure to clean up these slide pins. And always use a little bit of silicon paste on them. Be sure that the springs are located beneath the caliper. It sometimes happens that one of them is just sticking through the hole right here, so it needs to be nice and jumpy. And the kit came with new bolts for the caliper, so that's what we're going to use. And with that, we're done. The only thing we have to do is clean up the rotor as good as we can with some brake cleaner, of course. And be sure, before you're going to drive with the car, that you press the brake pedal a couple of times. And there you have it. How to change your disc brakes on a Renault Clio. If you have seen the wheel bearing video I did from the other Clio, then yeah, I already showed you most of this. So it's a straightforward job if you have, of course, the right diameter rotors. And as you can see, these discs are shot. They're just shot. I should have replaced them much earlier than I did. I did know that the brakes were bad, but I didn't know that they're that bad. Also, there are some big grooves in the pads also. This one is still okay, but and the other side, it's the same. So, but then again, the car did break pretty well, so yeah, we just have to wait and see if the Roadhouse discs are worth it. I do think they're just fine for the application that is my mom. And yeah, if there's something wrong with that, then we will find out together. But that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. And if you did, then please give it a like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do. And I will see you next time. Bye.